Steve Dotto here. I'm glad you're taking time to join me today. Evernote users, pay attention. We are going to take a look at an Evernote-powered blogging platform that's in very late beta called Pistachio. Now, when I first looked at this 3 months ago, I kind of had a little bit of trouble figuring out exactly where Pistachio might fit. I've never been a big blogger. I've never had a Tumblr blog or one of those kind of streaming linear blogs like that. So I didn't really see in my life where a tool like Pistachio might fit. Basically, what happens with Pistachio is you create an Evernote notebook that you will use to create blog posts. And by a special publishing process within those notes, a special way to save those notes, you can then create blog posts out of each individual note. So individual notes become individual blog posts. Now, it makes a lot of sense, but I didn't have a real-world application till a couple of weeks ago. I was speaking to a client, a transportation company, whose maintenance department was looking for some way to take Evernote notes and publish them out into an RSS feed to their teams. And I thought, wait a minute, there's that blogging platform called, I couldn't remember the name of it. I came home, looked it up, Pistachio, gave me cause to experiment with it, sign up, play with it. And indeed, it is a very, very slick implementation of creating blog posts out of Evernote notes. Now, you can figure out how that might work in your life. I'm going to show you how it works. And it's really quite simple. I'm going to take you, first of all, to my Pistachio site. When you sign up for Pistachio, it's free to sign up right now. As I say, they're in late beta. They do have a premium version that I think costs $5 a month that gives some extra features. But basically, you can create several different blogs, and they are just, they're kind of linear blogs. And here's my blog here called Dotto Tech. Now, when you sign up, there'll be permission granted for it to access your Evernote account. And then based on the name of your blog, they will create a new notebook in Evernote for you. Now, since I created a blog site called Dotto Tech, if I go into my Evernote notebook, I had a notebook, or into my Evernote account, I had a new notebook created called Dotto Tech right there. Now, within the Dotto Tech notebook, I can then create notes. And then if I choose to choose the term published as a tag, it will then take that note and publish it to my blog. It's really quite a simple process. Once you've set it up, it doesn't take a lot of thought, and it will be incredibly convenient for publishing this sort of content. And I should point out that it's not going to just publish to the blog, but there are ways for us to link this into Twitter, into Facebook, and then to some other online services as we move downstream. But let me just show you the way that it works. So I'm going to go to my site itself. There's my Pistachio blog. And you can see right here that these blog posts are the same as my notes here in Evernote. The process for creating a new blog post is dead simple. Within the notebook, you have to be in the right notebook, you create a new note. And I'm going to call this My Awesome Note with Cool Stuff. Cool Stuff. It's one of the best blog posts I think you could ever imagine. Now, if I just save this, nothing will happen. I create a tag, the publish tag. Once I've got the published tag in the note, it lets Evernote and Pistachio know that this is to be published as a blog post. I sync this to my online Evernote account from my desktop to my online account, and then I refresh the Pistachio page or my blog, and I should have my new note. There it is, my awesome note. How easy was that to publish a post? Now, we get to take advantage of most of Evernote's formatting. So we don't have to go into an HTML editor and do all that formatting in our blog post. I did a post here that I played with a lot of different formatting treatments. So I added color and size to the text. I added checkboxes. I looked for all of the different little features that were within Evernote. I added a graphic that I'd grabbed from Sketch. And I even recorded an audio note, as well as putting in bullet points and checkboxes. So I created that into a blog post, and some, not all, of those features came through. So here's that same blog post that we're looking at here. Here it is in the Pistachio blog. And in order, going from top to bottom, the text treatments all worked. Coloring text, changing the size, etc. The checkboxes did not work. The bullet points sort of worked. We ended up with straight bullet points as opposed to numbered bullet points that I'd created in my document. Still pretty darn good. I got really excited because I thought the voice annotation was going to go through, but indeed it didn't. Actually, what happened was there's a little voice annotation here, but the annotation did not make it through. It looks like it did, but there's actually nothing there to play. And the graphic came through clean. I played with a few other different types of data within the blog post. One of them is I created a post that had an embedded video from YouTube, and that came through just fine. That gave it, right, we see it right here, is we've got the nice YouTube video that plays fine. So you've got lots of different flexibility in using Pistachio for publishing your blog posts. Now, let's take a quick look at the dashboard and some of the settings so you can kind of get an idea of what you can do, extra things that you can do with a Pistachio blog. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to edit my account here. And here we set up all the names and that sort of stuff as far as the details of the account. We can set up social links. You can set up custom domains if you choose to. And you can also add Google Analytics and other in other hooks. In the import and sharing tab, we can set it up so that we can actually connect to Twitter and Facebook so that we can ask, so that based on the tags that we put in the note, we can have the same content published out to Twitter or published out to Facebook. That's pretty cool. It looks like they had it for Tumblr, but it's temporarily disabled. I don't know what's happening there, but this is the one that excites me. It's coming soon for WordPress, meaning that I soon may be able to publish my own on my own WordPress site from Evernote. I'm not sure I'm going to want to do that, but it's nice that I might be able to do that. And finally, we have a theme browser that allows us to choose different themes. And they are very simple and basic themes as far as what your blog post is going to look like within Pistachio. As I say, it's still early in its career. And this sort of a site isn't really designed to be a WordPress site with lots of different areas. It's really designed to be much more like a Tumblr site where we've just got basically post after post after post after post. I hope that you found this to be useful. Pistachio seems to me to be a great tool. They're actually not too far from me. They're over on Vancouver Island here, and I live in Vancouver. So they're kind of local kids or local people that I think have done a great job setting up a very creative application within Evernote. I trust that you found this video useful. If you have, please give us a like and don't forget to subscribe to our Dotto Tech channel. That way you will be the first to know about each week's brand new productivity videos. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.